Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. Today I am going to teach the CRUD part using Node.js, Express and MongoDB. Right? So how to make the professional CRUD using the Node.js, Express and MongoDB. Okay? It's a very simple stuff. Right? Let me move into the practical part. I'll show the demo on Postman. Right? This is very simple. Okay? So first, what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to test with the get all function to get to all the employee details, right? This is my MongoDB, right? RoboMongo, I have installed Mongo, RoboMongo. This is my database I have created as user. Inside the user database, we have a data, right? How to install the RoboMongo, all the stuff I taught in my previous video tutorials. Those who have not watched my previous tutorial, just go to my Tutors Funny channel. You can have it, my all over the previous tutorial, you can watch it. So this is the two data I have saved, right? This is the Kumar, this is the John, these are the data, right? So now first what I'm going to say, I'm going to get all the employee details. So get all, use a get all, this is RESTful API. So send it, this is the request get, the get request. You can get all the requests. Kumar, this is all details, it's getting from the database. And we will be getting as a JSON format, right? When you insert the record, what happens is I am going to calling the particular controller. So you have a controller, user is a controller, right? The controller, right? Create, right? So create, we have to go to the body, first name, last name. Here we have to type the names, right? So first I am going to create the name here as Raja Kumar, email Raja, password I'm just type something like this, right. Now this one should be the post request. Okay, when you are get the all the employee from the database, you have to use the get request. When you are posting the value, these are all the values are posting to the database, right? We have post request, right? Send user created. Here it's true, user created. If you want to check the with the database, you have to build in the third record. Raja Kumar, all the relevant information will be selected. Created. This is the passcode. This one should be the, we have to encrypt it. Okay. It will be encrypted password. I will teach how to create the encrypted password and all the stuff. Right. Don't worry about that. Okay. Right. Now here we created user successfully. Now I'm going to go to find the user. Right. You have to write, call the find one. Here you have to write ID, particular ID equal, what is the thing you are going to find, which record you are going to find on the database. I'm going to find this employee details, right? John James, this one, or I'm going to find this one, Kumar DS, or I just this one, this relevant ID. I just what's the key we have to put it here, the same thing you have to put it the URL, right? We are called here, send it. This one should be a get request. That's first get request. Okay, here you can get the relevant employee details. Kumar DS Peter, sort of stuff. Okay, if you have to find the another employee, second one, which one here, this one, here we go, copy this, find it, perfect. Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to update the record. So how to update the record here is, we have to write the relevant route. This is update route, update, right? It's update. Okay, this is route. Okay, now this is all the stuff I have teach. This is the ID we are going to update the record. So the ID of the information I'm going to update, right? So in the body part I'm going to update something like that. I'm going to update as the ID person, mean this one, this person, the person belongs to John James here. Here we have to write John instead of John Stephen. John Donald. Donald. I just give the name. Okay, John. Password also, I just change something like that. Now, if I call this one, click here. Yeah, this one should be not a get request. This is a patch request. So patch request. When you update record, patch request. Get through. It will be updated. Updated successfully. Now if you go and check, here now the current information will be there. Now if you have viewed about details, here instead of that, John, Steve, all the stuff are updated successfully. Right. Now I'm going to go to delete the record. So we have to write that remove. This is remove the particular person. I'm going to remove which one? The person of this person, John. This all stuff. The ID is 11-2. Now click. This one should be the delete. The delete. Okay. Okay. Here we have to click same button. Use a delete at. If you go to the database and refresh it, use a delete. Right here, there will be the no user there. I have two users only. Earlier, three users are there. I have deleted one user. Right? This simple one we have to delete. Right now, I'm going to go to remove these details. So let's go to the this one. And also copy. Go here. So first it. This one. User deleted. Now if you go and check what happened here, I deleted. Okay, deleted. Right. Okay, working successfully. I will teach how to do this one step by step. Right. Now first what I'm going to do is here. First I'm going to go to install the Node.js. So first I'm going to create a folder in my E drive. Okay, first you have to install Node.js, right? How to install the Node.js, you don't know. You just go to my previous videos and you will be watching. I will give the video description, my all the previous video tutorials about Node.js. You will be able to learn, right? So Node.js. Exercise. Right. This is the folder, right? Now here I'm going to create the Node.js, right? So you have to create cmd. Right. Here you have to create the npm init. I'm create a new project of Node.js. Right, you have to type enter. I don't need this one. If you want to fill, you can fill it. Okay, right, author and everything. Okay, now yes, you have to give there. Yes, your Node.js project has been created. Again, the package JSON, yes, and this one should be there. It's all the stuff you have to create. Here you will be able to see. Okay, right. So after that, what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to go to here we have to open the project in the VS Code. So you have to write code dot space dot, press enter key. The newly created project has been generated like this. Your newly created project, it will be created successfully. Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to install the relevant packages, right? So first I'm going to install the Express server. So how to install the Express? It's very simple. If you don't have to remember all the stuff, okay, you just go to type on the Google npm Express. Node.js, it will be they made Node.js for easy purpose, right? Here, so how to install the npm here, they will be telling the installation process like this. You just copy this one. Okay, you can see the download, weekly download, all the stuff of Express server, how to import the Express server, all of data, right? So you have to, right here what I'm going to do is here, you have open the terminal, right? Okay, this is the this one we have to given the ID terminal. This is our another terminal, that this is fast compared to this. Okay, so if you are here, I'm going to write npm i.express. I'm going to install the Express server, right? It takes some time to install the Express server in the machine. It cover about all over the libraries, right? After okay it will be installing. Okay, it installing. Okay, now installation completed. Okay, right, after that what I'm going to do is here, I am going to go to install another process, that is a npm database, right? If you install this data, if you want to interact with this Mongo database, So you have to download the this relevant libraries, right? NPM libraries. So there's a Mongoose. So how to install Mongoose library? Here, this one also copy back to my Node.js editor here. Okay, paste it here. Press enter. Right. It takes some time to install your database into your machine. Okay, this is the important process. You must do it. Okay, right? When you are installed the Node.js, right? Okay, the installation process is started. You have to wait until the process is completed, right? So this is the things we have to do, right? Okay, here notice that we have a additional folder will be created. Okay, this additional package is the only when you open the Node.js into our VS Code, we show the first time only the package.json will only there. After that, you can see here, after install the Express server, you have a additional folder has been created. It's called as Node modules, right? If you expand this one, so all the modules will be reside on this folder, okay? This all the Node.js modules, okay? This all the modules are more important in order to run the Node.js application, right? Now here, Mongoose library also downloaded successfully, right? Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to go to create the file. So not here, you have to create here, right click, new file. This file I'm going to name it as server.js. This is a very important stuff, server.js, right? Okay, right. Now let's back to our previous project. First step, what I'm going to do is here, server.js. I have to import this one, expert server, this package, right? Express. Okay, here what I did here is I have created the this is how we have to import the Express server. The in Java, if you are imported any classes, how to write the classes, import. If you are write the swing classes, how to write import java.javax.swing. That's how we have to import the classes. In Node.js, you have to import like this var express require this express JS. The express JS, you have to create the object express, you have to put into this variable server, right? Okay, now this all the express libraries are reside on here, right? When you run the application, you have to call this one, okay? Perfect, right? After that, what I'm going to do is here, let's go here, we have to Mongoose, also we have to call this Mongoose class, so it import the Mongoose. This how we have to import var Mongoose required Mongoose, right? This all the packages are it will be there here. When I install the Mongoose, installation process also they are they given here. This how we have to initialize in your computer. It will be telling like that, right? You can use constant also, constant variable also. Otherwise, you can use var. Okay, that is not a problem. Okay. After that, what I'm going to do is here, we have to connect with the Mongoose, right? So first, whether the Mongoose and server, first we have to connect the listening port and everything, server post, whether it is connected or not. You have to write control C to copy this one. We have to put it here, right? The server port we are using to this port, right? I am going to change the port as here 7. This is the port we are using to running our Express server, right? Okay, server. This is the server which are running to Node.js 2 and communicate, right? We are coming to the server. Server listen port is this. Okay. Okay. Whether we have to select whether it is connected or not, first we have to check, right? So first, right? How to run the Node.js? So we have to save all. Node server dot js. You have to write like press enter key. Yes, started. So if the server is started, mean our application is working successfully. Where our application is running successfully if the server is started successfully. Right. It is started. If there are any problem, it show the error messages. Right. If there are any problem with the port, it will be show the error. Your problem is working successfully. Right. After that, what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to do the another stuff is here simply we have write server. The server means the server listen. We have to create the port, this one port. Here we have to write a function check here, right? Simply you have to write like this here. Server write, we have to write like this. We have to create a simple function check error. You have to write like the function comma, you have put the comma, after that you have paste. This is where the Node.js function you have created in the efficient way, right? If the there are many students having this problem, right? That's why I will show you how the easy way to create the function in Node.js. Very simple, right? Function, function name. We have to pass one argument error. If there is an error, it passing the console, right? The error message will be displayed as error. If it is a success message, the server is stuck, right? Working perfect. Now I'm going to go to create the establish the database connection, right? In order to connect MongoDB and Node.js, right? Okay, I'm going to establish the database connection, right? I already done it my, right? This is the connectivity, control C to copy, control C to paste, right? Now I will be explained, don't worry about that. I have created the database which name is online class this one, M1. I just created a database. You can create any name that is your wish, okay? I just give the name, right like this, okay? So this name, Mongo's Connect. Yeah, this is the name. Okay, this is the port which I am connecting. You can connect the port. You can check the port, whether the port, what is the port here. Here, this is the port. Right. Now, let's back to our VS Code editor. Right. Now, let's check whether our MongoDB connection is succeed or not. So, here, first what I am going to do is here, go back to our... Right. Now, let's check. Now I am going to go to here again. I am going to control C to. I am going to again run the server. Right here. MongoDB is connected successfully. Right. If you stop and run control C to stop again, you have to type node server.js. Right. Now your server is connected successfully. Okay. Right. Now if there is any error, it will be throw the error. There is no error, right? This is how we have connected the server, MongoDB server, right? Very successful, right? Now what I'm going to do is here, all the stuff are successfully. Now I'm going to go to, I already done this code. I just show you for the beginning part. I will explain it my previous code, right? So it will be very easy to complete the project. Instead of writing this all the stuff, it takes too much of time to complete the project, right? So I already explained this stuff, right? So let's what I'm going to do is here, right? Here now, this is my previous project. I have shown the demo, right? So this is the MongoDB connection. I already show how to connect the MongoDB. All the stuff I show you. So here MongoDB, we have write the port which is this one, this port, right? So here this is a port. I show you, right? So that what is the database? The database online class, this is the database name we have to mention here, right? Very simple. The how to connect the MySQL, the same thing. This is the your database is located on the localhost. This is the port where your server is running on, the MongoDB server is running on. This is the database where you are created in your Mongo's database, right? So here, right, this is the permission we have to write, user URL pass dot true, right? So this is how we have to create it, right? This is how we have created the MongoDB, right? This is also the same thing, how to test with the error and all. This we have to connect it here. We have to test like this here. We have to write a separate function. We have to write a separate function. We have to undo it here. You just, we have the error DB. This all the function is separate. You have to write like this. You just copy, control X to cut off. After that, you have to put the comma and paste it. Now it will be getting very simple. This is how you have simply you have write the function, right? Okay, very simple, right? Right. Now what I'm going to do is here, first we have to test with the URL and everything here, right? So here we have to right. Yeah, we know this one, right? Right. Now first what I'm going to do is here, first we have to create the routes. So we have to create the folder routes here. How to create the folder? I have created route folder. You have to create new folder, name it as routes.routes. Okay, inside the routes, what happens is the routes inside routes. I am going to create the file new file. Here I am going to name it as routes.js. We have to write the name. Okay, we write like routes.js. You press enter key, the file will be created like this. Here first what I did here is, here also we have to implement the Express.js library, okay, in route file also. After that, this is a controller, okay, I will be explained later on. So here to write the concern routes, right, the routes we have to set into the Express, we have set into the routes, right, calling the routes. So Express dot router, there will be the predefined property called router. We have to pass in the router object here, right. After that, we have to write router dot route. Here we have mentioned all the routes, okay. When the user requests the user get all, if the request coming like this, what happens, we have to get all the data from the database. I will explain it with all the stuff when I show the demo also, okay. When the request is coming from get all, okay, what happened, it's getting all the user details, it's getting all the user details, okay. Okay, that's how the these things work, right. So what I did here is user get all. So what happened is, I have created, when the route requests the get all, it goes to the controller, user controller, get data controller action method. So it goes like this. This one should be the our user controller I have created, right? User control here. I have created the separate folder here, user folder. Right click, new folder. I have created the user folder. Inside the user folder, I have created three files. UserController.js, UserModel.js, UserService.js, right? Let me look at the UserController.js. What I did here is a simple one, okay? First, what I did here is, we have created the here, when the routes request the all the get information about the user, it will be calling the UserController.get data controller. So it goes to user controller get data. This is the function. This function has a two arguments, request and request and response. req mean request, res mean response, right. It get the request. What happen is, you have create the variable employee details, user service, you have get user service, we have to get in the user service, we have get all the db information about the employee, okay. So it goes to the user db here. This is how we are getting through the models. It's getting through the models, right. The service what does is, all the data, employee data, will be available in the Mongoose database. The when the routes calling the url get all, it requests the controller. Controller what does is, controller get the request, it's sending to the service. Service what does is serving to communicate with the database. How to communicate with the service through the database? Through the model. So the model, we have to create the schema. This is called a schema, right. So here first we have to add the package, right. Mongoose package, var mongoose required like this, right. We have created the database schema like this. Okay, we have to create the mongoose schema. We have to create the variable schema, mongoose.schema. User schema, we have to create a schema, new schema, create the object. This is the schema we have created. This schema, this all the column, this all the name should be matched with the same name of the database columns. First name, last name, email and password. Okay, you have to, if the name difference, it's not work, right? So this all the name should match with the same name. Okay, this all the name should be matched with the same name, then only the it will be interact with the database, right. The model will be interact with the database, the name should be matched, okay. So this is the same name here, you have to write it, okay. After that, what does is this model, you have to export into the outside. So how to export it into the outside, you have to write model.exports equal mongoose.model. Here if you have to write, here when you write the schema in Mongoose, you must know this stuff. If you write this user only, it not considered. You have to put the S correctly. Okay. Singular, plural. This is plural. You have to write like this. Okay. Schema. Okay. This is how you have, it will be connected, this schema. Now this all schema will be exported to outside. Okay, then we are, the classes will be accessed this model anywhere. okay, if you are right, okay. This, if you are right, the model export mean every where it will be accessed. So here this what does this now? Model export the get data service. What happen is you have to write the promise. You have to write the function which is a promise. What is the promise function? What the does is there will be that we are passing two arguments, resolve and reject. Reject what does is when the errors come. Error might be come as a database table error, otherwise database error. Okay, it might be getting, it will be reject. Okay, if there is any problem, okay, it will be rejecting. Okay, so if there is no error, it will be resolved. The data will be successfully fine. It will be resolved, right? If the data is not available, that also resolved. Database any problem, it will be rejected. Okay, so we have to write how to find all the records from the database. You have to write this code in MongoDB. You have to write this like this. User model means this is user model schema we are getting here. You have simply write find. This all you have to find. If you take an example of SQL, outright select all from the particular database name. Here we don't have to mention any name. You have to mention only the model. Okay, the data is coming from the model through the model. You have to only like model dot find. Only write like this. The data will be coming like this. So you have to write the function return data error or error and result. Right. So if there is any error, it will be reject. If there is no error, it will be resolve and solve the output here. The output will be go to here. Output will be returning to here. It will be returning to the service. The service, right? The service returning to the controller. Controller getting this one, this function, this all the data information. It is passing to the employee details. The employee details will be passing to the response send me. It is sending the response here through the data. Okay, this data, the output will be displayed. Okay, it will be sending the data. The output will be display as a JSON format. I already show in this my demo part. This all the stuff, right? How the get all requests work, right? I no need to show you again, because it takes too much of time to complete the project. I already shown this one, how the get all work, routes work, all the stuff in my demo, right? If you are not watching, you see my demo. I will be taught, right? When I show the demo for the first, for the beginning of the video, right? How to get request work, right? After that, we have to touch with the create. When the request is coming like this, create, what happens is goes to the user controller create action method. So it goes to the user controller create action method. This is how you have to come. Okay, so here you can check with the body. It's like it is coming here. This also two argument, request and response. It is, you can check whether the request is coming like this, request body. You write var status service create service also. Here also create the function also, create user service. Here you have a request body. Okay, what is the data you are typing here through the body? Your body, I have show you the data. What are the data you are typing? Okay, JSON format in my demo. This all the data is taken like this. It goes to the create user DB. So it goes like this here. So here the create user DB. Here what I did here is here also I have. Here also I have created the user created function, user details. User details means all the user details. We have created the user details like this. Okay, so here this one should be argument. Here you try the promise. The promise here also you have set is a resolve and reject, right? So you have write the model var model data equal user model. I mean this is a user model. I have to call it here the user model. We have created the object called user model data. The user model data dot first name, this first name, last name, email and password. This all the things are coming from this model name. This all the names coming from the model, right? It's coming from the model, right? This is the form data. Okay, this is a form data. We have to write the form data. Form data mean what is the data you are typing. Okay, this form data, right? Okay, this is coming here, right? After that, what I did here is this all the stuff are okay. Now when you type the password, this password should be your encrypted. You have tried the encrypted. The encrypted also you have to go and find the npm. That npm encrypt. You have to find it here. Npm encrypt. Encrypted. The encrypted, you can find it. Here you can find the encrypt. In the here the encrypt. Here this is not the encrypt. So just type it. Here the npm search encrypt. Okay, here you can find it. Okay, how to encrypt encrypt password. So here already I encrypted here. This is the code. Don't worry about this source code I provide. Here I have given some or one key. You can get a simple key here, right? You have to write encrypt, encryptor, encrypt here, user password. The password you are typed on this one. You get the password and put it here. Okay, this password, the password you have to get it here. It will be put it here, password here. It will be here encrypted. If you have put it here, the password will be encrypted. Here you have to write user model dot save. You are calling this function save. If there is no error, it will be, if there is error, it will be rejected. If there is no error, data will be stored in the database. It will be, it is true, right? It's true. It will be return, it is returning to here. Service will be passing to the controller. Controller here. Data will be, you can get the status recorded. Status. If the status is coming successfully, here response you are sending to the server. Response dot send. Here we have write user created successfully. If there is any error while creating the user, response sending the error message, error creating user. Okay, this serve the our routes work, create route works. Very simple, create route for this one, right? After that we have look at the things of model, this one, third one mean routes, go to the routes, find record. Find also I have to show you the demo, create also show the demo. Find also how the work, when the request coming like this, find user, find like this. Okay, when the user find request, here you are writing user, find request, right? When the request coming like this, what happened is goes to the controller, this method, find one user controller method, right? So here, you have to go to the, you have to click like this, it goes here. So here, what you have done here is all the things are exported here, the all the functions, right? Model export here, this get data, we have to export it, create data, export it, the find data, we have to export it. Likewise, you have to export one by one. So you have to write like here, this the same thing here also, well, the find function, get the request. Get the request, your console, you have tested whether request is coming or not. The result service, you are throwing to the control will be passing the request in the service to handle it. Service passing, so in the service, we have a method called find user. If you go to the find one user, you have create the object user details, the same thing. Here also, we have write the promise. Okay, promise already I explained whether request is success, resolve, failure, reject, right? You have get the what the details are coming, user model, find one, what the request coming, there will be a predefined called find one. Okay, here we have to checking the user ID or username, all the stuff. Okay, it will be finding the record, and if the record is available, it is resolved and sending to the response, right? So response is goes to the controller. Controller will be, if the data is available, is getting here, passing to the result. Result will be, if the result is available, it will be producing the relevant matching ID. If the ID will be matching, the relevant details should be displayed as a result like this. If there any fail, if the record is not found, it will be passing the error, user not found. Like this of the find user controller works. Right. If you go to the here the find also, here also we have to export it out, find one. Okay, after that if you go to the routes, which is a update, update routes, you have to write user update ID. You have to write like this, simple. When you found the record, update the record, right? Okay, here, if you are not, is when you are update the record, you have to write like this. This is a get request. If you are sending the request, first request, we are creating the first request. If you update, we are calling the patch. Okay, this is a patch request, right? Patch, we have to write controller, update controller. If you go to the update controller, update controller. Here, get the request. It is passing the user service update method, right? If you go here, passing both. Okay, get the request. Relevant ID as a param. Here, right? Request ID. Get the ID. What is the relevant ID? Should be primary key, so that get the relevant ID information about the record. The, if you change anything about the changes, if you click the relevant ID match record should be updated. So get the ID, your body. So it goes to the service update one user method. So go here, get the ID and details. Here we have write promise. We have write resolve reject, right? So you get the ID. Here to the method called find by ID and update. User ID and details, the relevant ID details should be updated like this. It will be, if all the success succeed, it goes the resolve. If this is a failure, it goes to reject. It will be passing to the controller. It is passing to the result. If the user is updated successfully, passing here message. If it's any failure, it's coming here, right? The same thing does the delete method as well. So if it's a, when the request is coming as a delete, okay, what is the relevant ID of the information? It is the method, it is the action method delete. Okay, here this is the patch update. When you update the record, patch request, delete record, delete request, user control, delete action method. It goes to delete method, action method. You call, you can see here, get the request. Okay, this is ID only, we are getting the ID. Get the ID and delete the entire information. So here, user service, you are passing the ID. So you go to the method, this is service, get the ID. User model, we have a predefined method called find one and delete. This is the user defined. Okay, here find here, it will be there. Okay, you can pick up that. Get the ID, entire record will be deleted. The model, right? So if the thing is succeed, it will be calling the resolve. If it's a failure, it's calling the reject. If it succeed, it is calling returning the output here. Getting the controller, user controller, and passing the result into the result variable. If the result, if the user deleted successfully, get the result, it passing here. Response sent, we have to pass the message this one. If there any failure, it will be sending the request as user delete fail. Okay, this is how our CRUD system work in Node.js. Okay. Just don't worry about this. All the source code I provide in my website, Tutors Funny, I'll be explaining. Thanks for watching. If you have any doubt on this, you can ask me anytime. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.